freedom. He drank wine all night, the night of the 28th, and he kept thinking of her. The way she walked, talked, and loved. The way she told him things that seemed true but were not. And he knew the color of each of her dresses and her shoes. He knew the stock. Oh, shit. I never met a man I didn't like. Jesus Christ. Now there's a real brain for you, right? Looking toward God. Anyhow, let's get on. Let's get on with the next fucking thing. I'm doing a worse and worse job, but let's try and wrap it out. This one's called... Love is a piece of paper torn to bits. All the beer was poisoned, and the captain went down, and the mate and the cook, and we had nobody to grab sail. And the northwester ripped the sheets like toenails. We pitched like crazy, the hull tearing its sides, and all the time in the corner, some punk had a drunken slut, my wife, and was pumping away like nothing was happening. And the cat kept looking at me, crawling in the pantry amongst the clanking dishes with flowers and vines painted on them, until I couldn't stand it anymore and took the thing and heaved it over the side. Finish. The hearse comes through the room filled with the beheaded, the disappeared, the living mad. The flies are a glue of sticky paste, their wings will not lift. I watch an old woman beat her cat with a broom. The weather is unendurable, a dirty trick by God. The water has evaporated from the toilet bowl. The telephone rings without sound, a small limp arm petering against the bell. I see a boy on his bicycle, his spokes collapse, his tires turn into snakes and melt away. The newspaper is oven hot. Men murder each other in the streets without reason. The worst men have the best jobs, the best men have the worst jobs, or are unemployed, or locked in madhouses. I have 4 cans of food left. Air-conditioned troops go from house to house, from room to room, jailing, shooting, bayoneting the people. We have done this to ourselves. We deserve this. The genius of the crowd. There is enough treachery, hatred, violence, absurdity in the average human being to supply any given army on any given day. And the best at murder are those who preach against it. And the best at hate are those who preach love. And the best at war, finally, are those who preach peace. Those who preach God need God. Those who preach peace do not have peace. Those who preach love do not have love. Beware the preachers. Beware the knowers. Beware those who are always reading books. Beware those who either detest poverty or are proud of it. Beware those quick to praise, for they need praise in return. Beware those quick to censure. They are afraid of what they do not know. Beware those who seek constant crowds. They are nothing alone. Beware the average man, the average woman. Beware their love. Their love is average, seeks average, but there is genius in their hatred. There is enough genius in their hatred to kill you, to kill anybody. Not wanting solitude, not understanding solitude, they will attempt to destroy anything that differs from their concepts. Not being able to create art, they will not understand art. They will consider their failure as creators only as a failure of the world. Not being able to love fully, they will believe your love incomplete, and then they will hate you. And their hatred will be perfect. At the end of feet, the blackbird walks. Shocked by palisades of ice and worn out shoes. Shocked by nerve gas. Shocked by pinnacles of spinach. Shocked by the broken winged bluebird. Old Notre Dame football teams run through my room, sands whirl inside stovepipes, never getting a Pulitzer Prize. Shakespeare's 401, Joe Louis is 51, a young boy stands outside throwing dust dry rocks against a garage. Shocked by the body's limpet drag, disease, lab. Shocked by tourniquets of music in elevators. Not shocked to learn that Beethoven was a drunkard. The angular daydream huddles against the fence like an old man. Jesus, Charlie, it says, Jesus, Charlie, they surely got us now. Then night fear. Fear of never sleeping with a young girl who never heard of Rimba. Fear of platitude and poverty. Fear of the long death. Fear of cameras and landlords and bosses. Fear of children and wives. Fear of cancer and round shoulders. Fear that Sartre is asleep. Fear that Janae is kidding. Fear that there isn't anybody here. In a dozen years, I will be gray and almost dead. In a dozen years, I will be dead. At the end of feet, the blackbird walks. The woman behind me dries her pants on the heater. China and Russia curse at the bar. France sits back holding a small blade in the pocket. I wish I were truly gross and underweight, the way people say I am. I wish I were truly gross. Weighed 366 pounds. Sat at a back table in Paris, six novels a month. I'm ready to die, waiting, eating something out of a pot. A one-hand line. Regarding the women, the world is still going to ground. Young boys learn to know how it's done, what the equation is. And I am, after all, truly gross. I get up and walk out, electric into darkness, and crack my cane head against the building. Bap! And that is it. Something for the touts, the nuns, the grocery clerks, and you. We have everything and we have nothing. And some men do it in churches, and some men do it by tearing butterflies in half. And some men do it in Palm Springs, laying it into butter blondes with Cadillac soles. Cadillacs and butterflies, nothing and everything. The face melting down to the last puff in a cellar in Corpus Christi. There's something for the touts, the nuns, the grocery clerks, and you. Something at 8 a.m., something in the library, something in the river. Everything and nothing. In the slaughterhouse, it comes running along the ceiling on a hook, and you swing it. One, two, three, and then you've got it. $200 worth of dead meat. Its bones against your bones. Something and nothing. It's always early enough to die, and it's always too late. And the drill of blood in the basin white, it tells you nothing at all. And the grave diggers playing poker over 5 a.m. coffee, waiting for the grass to dismiss the frost. They tell you nothing at all. We have everything, we have nothing. Days with the glass edges and the impossible stink of river moss, worse than shit. Checkerboard days of moves and counter moves, fagged interests with as much sense in defeat as in victory. Slow days like mules humping and flagged and sullen and sun-glazed up a road where a madman sits waiting among blue jays and wrens. Netted in and sucked a flaky gray. Good days too of wine and shouting, fights in alleys, fat legs of women striven around your bowel, buried in moans, the signs and bull rings like diamond-hollering Mother Capri. Violets coming out of the ground, telling you to forget the dead armies and the loves that robbed you. Days when children say funny and brilliant things, like savages trying to send you a message through their bodies while their bodies are still alive enough to transmit and feel and run up and down without locks and paychecks and ideals and possessions and beetle-like opinions. Days when you can cry all day long in a green room with the door locked. Days when you can laugh at the bread man because his legs are too long. Days of looking at hedges and nothing and nothing. The days of the bosses, yellow men with bad breath and big feet, men who look like frogs, hyenas, men who walk as if melody had never been invented. Men who think it is intelligent to hire and fire and profit. Men with extensive wives they possess like 60 acres of ground to be drilled or shown off or to be walled away from the incompetent. Men who'd kill you because they're crazy and justify it because it's the law. Men who stand in front of windows 30 feet wide and see nothing. Men with luxury yachts who can sail around the world and yet never get out of their vest pockets. Men like snails, men like eels, men like slugs, not as good. And nothing. Getting your last paycheck at a harbor, at a factory, at a hospital, at an aircraft plant, at a penny arcade, at a barber shop, at a job you didn't want anyway. Income tax, sickness, servility, broken arms, broken heads, all the stuffing come out like an old pillow. We have everything and we have nothing. Some do it well enough for a while and then give way. Fame gets them or disgust or age or lack of proper diet or ink across the eyes or children in college or new cars or broken backs while skiing in Switzerland or new politics or new wives or just natural change and decay. The man you knew yesterday hooking for 10 rounds or drinking for 3 days and 3 nights by the sawtooth mouth is now just something under a sheet or a cross or a stone or under an easy delusion. Or packing a Bible or a golf bag or a briefcase. How they go, how they go. All the ones you thought could never go. Days like this. Day today. Maybe the rain on the window trying to get through to you. What do you see today? What is it? Where are you? The best days are sometimes the first, sometimes the middle, and even sometimes the last. The vacant lots are not back. Churches in Europe on postcards are not bad. People in wax museums frozen into their best virility are not bad. Horrible, but not bad. The cannon, think of the cannon. And toast for breakfast and coffee hot enough to know your tongue is still there. Three geraniums outside a window trying to be red and trying to be pink and trying to be geranium. No wonder sometimes the women cry. No wonder the mules don't want to go up the hill. Are you in a hotel room in Detroit looking for a cigarette? One more good day, a little bit of it. And as a nurse nurses come out of the building after their shift, having had enough. Eight nurses with different names and different places to go, walking across the lawn. Some of them want cocoa and a paper. Some of them want a hot bath. Some of them want a man. Some of them are hardly thinking at all. Enough and not enough. Arcs and pilgrims, oranges, gutters, ferns, antibodies, boxes of tissue paper. In the most decent, sometimes sun, there is the soft smoke feeling from urns and the canned sound of old battle planes. And if you go inside and run your finger along the window ledge, you'll find dirt, maybe even earth. And if you look out the window, there will be the day. And as you get older, you'll keep looking, sucking your tongue in a little. Ah, no, maybe.